Hello viewers, welcome to Elim TV, a station where you watch, interact, and also learn. Your teacher today is Mr. Wanyoike, an agriculture teacher. We are in today's lesson, Form 3 Work, Lesson 4. And the topic is Livestock Production 3. And the subtopic, we are dealing with the breeding. On to the lesson objective. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to, number one, explain the meaning of the term breeding, and number two, explain various methods of breeding. What is breeding? Breeding is the process of mating of the selected males and females in a certain animal to produce offspring of required characteristics. For example, you can have a look here. Breeding of a pure red cattle and pure white cattle, and therefore the resultant offspring which is desired with the desired characteristic is a roan which will have a mixture of red and white color. Then we have reasons for breeding. Why do we carry out breeding programs? The number one, to expand the inherited potential of an animal. The second one, to introduce a new gene. And the third one, to overcome the production problem, such as diseases. Then number four, to satisfy the consumer's taste. And finally, for economic reasons, because after breeding, you'll come up with a highly productive animal, which fetch high prices when it comes to selling of those animals. We have terms used. We have dominant gene. A dominant gene is a superior gene which normally masks the characteristic of the inferior or recessive gene. And also, a dominant gene is the one which normally expresses itself fully both in homozygous and heterozygous condition. Then we have a recessive gene. What is a recessive gene? A recessive gene is an inferior gene. It is a gene which normally represents itself fully only in homozygous dominant recessive condition case. Then we go to a dominant gene. For example, here we have a very tall Friesian cow. The gene for tallness and also the gene for big size is dominant. Then we have the codominance. A codominance, on the other hand, is a combined, it is a situation whereby there are two genes in an allele, and each gene or in the allele represent itself equally. And for example, we can have a codominance gene whereby a pure red gene represented by capital R, two capital R, and a pure white breed that is represented by two capital W. After you cross the two animals, you'll get an offspring having a roan coat, a roan color, that is a mixture of red and white. Why? Because the two genes, the gene that determine for the red color and also the gene that determine for white color, are codominant. It means that they represent them equally in a heterozygous condition. Then breeding system, we have two. The first one we have inbreeding, and inbreeding we have crossbreeding and also we have line breeding. And in crossbreeding, these refer to as mating very closely related animals, such as, for example, you can have siblings, a brother and a sister cow being mated, or a parent a bull mating to the daughter. Then we have the line breeding. This is the mating of distantly related animals that share a common ancestor, for example, cousins. Then we have the outbreeding, and there are several. We have outcrossing, and outcrossing, the first one is the one which is referred to as mating unrelated animals within the same breed. For example, a Friesian cow bull in Kenya supplying the semen to a Friesian cow from Britain. And that is what we refer to as outcrossing. Then we have crossbreeding. Crossbreeding, on the other hand, it is the mating of two animals to form from different breeds, for example, a Friesian and a Jersey. Then we have upgrading. Upgrading, on the other hand, is a type of crossing where the female of low-grade stock is mated with a pure breed sire, that is a bull of high or desirable characteristics. Then on the from there we will go to the recessive gene. As I explained it, we can have a recessive gene in terms of dwarfness. We have an animal here which is very dwarf, meaning that even the offspring will also be dwarf because they will have inherited that trait, which is a recessive gene from the mother. And on the left picture, we have a tall animal and having a tall calf, meaning that that is a dominant gene. Then we have come to the end of today's lesson, and I'm going to end the lesson with giving you assignment. The first question, state any two types of breeding system, and the second question, state any four reasons for breeding. For reference, you can refer from Secondary Agriculture Student Book 3, and the publisher is the Kenya Literature Bureau. For more information, you can reach us at Elim TV using the following addresses. Using the SMS, using the number, which is well displayed for you. Then you can use the YouTube at Elim TV, the Facebook platform at Elim TV, and finally you can tweet us at elimu_TV_KE. Thank you for joining me in this lesson. Till next lesson, goodbye.